بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear respected brothers, Ramadan Mubarak for all of you inshallah. Alhamdulillah, Ramadan started and this is a very great opportunity for all of us to be more closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And it's a great gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to attend Ramadan. As we said before, attending Ramadan is a very great gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to any Muslim. Because some of our brothers or sisters passed away before Ramadan and they had no chance to attend Ramadan. But for us, alhamdulillah, we are very lucky that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us this great gift to attend Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen. One very important thing we have to believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need any of our ibadat. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need our fasting in Ramadan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need our prayers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need any kind of our worship to Him. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in Al-Quran, وَاللَّهُ الْغَنِيُّ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ أَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَاءُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ. O people, you are very poor and in need to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who is not in need for anyone. In Al-Quran al-Kareem, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying in many ayat that He doesn't need anything from His creations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, إِنْ أَحْسَنْتُمْ أَحْسَنْتُمْ لِأَنفُسِكُمْ وَإِنْ أَسَأْتُمْ فَلَهَا. The meaning that if you do some of the good deeds, it's for you. The reward will be for you. And in the other side, if doing some of bad deeds or sins or whatever, the punishment will be to you. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need any of our ibadat. So when we are fasting in Ramadan, we have to put this in our heart and in our hearts and in our minds that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't need anything from us. And the benefits of our ibadat, it's coming back to us, not to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Hadith Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Hadith Qudsi in Sahih Muslim, narrated by Abu Dharr al-Ghifari radiallahu anhu. First, before saying the Hadith Qudsi, we have to explain what is the meaning of Hadith Qudsi. Actually, we have three types of revelation or three types of very important things teaching in Islam. Al-Quran al-Kareem, number one. Al-Hadith al-Qudsi, number two. And then Al-Hadith al-Nabawi, number three. Al-Quran al-Kareem, as we know, the words and the meanings, it's all from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And nobody can change even one letter in the Holy Quran. But for Hadith Qudsi, the meaning from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the words chosen by the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But the Hadith Nabawi, the meanings and the words are from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So in the Hadith Qudsi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying, Ya ibadi, O my slaves, if all of you, men and jinn, are on the highest level of belief, iman, and good deeds, they will not increase anything to me. And if all of you, men and jinn, also not on the good way, they will not decrease anything from my kingdom. So we are really in need to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we have to put in our minds that our fasting in Ramadan, it's for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to train us to be more good, to improve our characters, to be more closer to Him. And this, of course, will benefit us, inshallah, in this life and in the hereafter. We pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help us to increase our good deeds in Ramadan and to accept us in this great month of Ramadan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And see you, inshallah, in the next message.